Hey there, Careblazer, welcome back. In today's video, I'm gonna answer a question that I receive quite frequently in different emails and YouTube comments. Basically, the question goes something like this. Did I handle the situation with my loved one in the best way possible? Did I answer their question correctly? Did I handle the situation correctly? So I'm gonna give you a pretty simple way for you to be able to determine whether or not your answers and responses to your loved one are working for you. But I first just wanna say that in dementia care, it is very rare that there is a one way to handle the situation, right? What's right for one careblazer may not be right for another careblazer. Now, I do personally have some cardinal rules on dementia care that I think would be great for all careblazers to follow, like you shouldn't really argue with somebody who has dementia, right? There's some basic things like that. And if you've been following my videos for a while, you probably already know what they are. However, what I do want to say is that for the most part, there is no one right way. There is no one best way. What works for you may not work for somebody else, okay? So just keep that in mind. But basically, let me answer the question. It's pretty simple. The way that you know whether or not you are responding in a good way to your loved one with dementia or in a way that fits for your loved one with dementia is just to pay attention to how your loved one reacted. After you explained yourself or after you answered their question or after you handled their situation, did your loved one become more upset and agitated or were they more calm and went about their day, right? And I think that's just important for all of us to realize is that sometimes you are looking for answers outside of yourself or outside of your situation or to different professionals when really, Careblazer, you know what's best for your loved one. So just pay attention. How do they respond after you reacted that way? Their behaviors will often tell you, ooh, I don't think that worked, or ooh, okay, that seemed to go over well. I need to take note of that and try to use that approach again in the future. Now, it's pretty easy for you to know when something has gone terribly wrong, right? If you provided an explanation or said something and your loved one went off the handle, that's a pretty easy way to say, okay, that didn't go over well. I need to change my approach. But I think where your questions are coming in, I think what's really driving these questions that I'm receiving is when you are responding to your loved one in a way that doesn't make much sense to you, that feels foreign to you or feels awkward to you. Because in dementia, when you're providing really great care to your loved one, you're having to learn a whole new way of interaction. You're having to communicate in a whole new way. If you watched my video from last week on how to best communicate with somebody with dementia, then you know that it requires a whole new language. It's almost as if you are talking to somebody who no longer speaks your same language or is from a whole nother culture. And so I think the discomfort many of you are feeling is the discomfort of, I just handled that situation in a way that I've never handled a situation with another human being. And even though my loved one seemed to take it okay, I still don't know if it's right. So some examples of this would be when your loved one tells you they just got off the phone with a family member who's been dead in 5 years. And rather than telling your loved one, you couldn't have got off the phone with that person, they've been dead for 5 years. Instead, you said something like, oh, that's nice, how are they doing? And then that brings up a bunch of uncomfort and dis-ease for you because it's not the way you would respond to most people. And so it's situations like that, I think, that are driving those questions that you're having. But Careblazer, you have to come up with a way to respond to your loved one that feels right to you, that feels okay to you. It doesn't mean it feels comfortable. It doesn't mean it makes sense in your mind. It means that you're stretching yourself and you're trying to find a way that makes sense in your loved one's mind in a way that doesn't lead them to be more frustrated and angry and irritable and agitated and anxious, right? You're becoming a really great careblazer by thinking outside of the box, doing trial and error, coming up with ways to respond, and then taking note on how your loved one respond. That's the best teacher. That's what's going to guide the way you interact with your loved one. Now, just know that what is working for you right now, the responses and the way you handle situations right now, they might have to change in the future, right? As the disease progresses, they may no longer work. And ways that you are finding do not work right now for your loved one, they might work in the future. So as the disease progresses, you change your approach. But Careblazer, you will know whether or not you are doing the right thing just by watching how your loved one responds to you. Now, keep in mind, it's not only their verbal communication that will tell you whether or not you're on the right track, it's also their nonverbal communication. So did they continue to seem anxious or worked up during the day? Did they seem more restless or fidgety after you handled the situation the way you did? So take note. And that's a lot of times why I also recommend Careblazers to keep a notebook or a journal about the different behaviors and what you're seeing, because you will start to notice patterns and you will start to find out for yourself what are some of the best approaches your loved one handles and the ones that don't seem to work at all. All right, Careblazer, I hope this was helpful for you. If you want to make sure you don't miss out on future videos, go ahead and hit that red subscribe button on your screen. Join the Careblazer family. It's completely free. I'd love for you to be here. And I can look forward to next week when I come back with another video. Careblazer, keep up the good work. I know it's not easy. I know it's hard, but I know that you can do this. All right, bye.